Well, we're building a house for competition in Washington, D.C. Involves 20 colleges from around the world, 800 square feet. We're building it in modules because it needs to be transported to the National Mall for a contest in Washington, D.C. in October.
This project has been a tremendous experience. I kind of got into it through my advisor because I'm in the Solar Energy Lab, and it's just been this phenomenal experience. I've learned so much about home construction and architecture and how we incorporate that into engineering. It's been a fantastic learning experience.
It's been kind of crazy. Earlier on, we took a little bit more relaxed approach to it, inviting everyone into, you know, design sessions, into discussions about what the concept should be. As we get closer and closer to the end, right now we're 6 months off, we're kind of in a frantic mode where we're doing both construction and fixing up drawings and dealing with communication stuff. So our team is really, really busy.
I think what we're trying to do is just essentially raise awareness about all the things that people can do to have a house that might be a solution to some of the problems that we are facing. So when we build a solar house, we're really trying to use all the technology we can and showcase it in ways that maybe the public can see and understand how they might be able to implement it in the same way or possibly in an entirely different way.
That's the whole idea of this type of house, is we're using, for the most part, very conventional building materials, 2x4 stick construction. We're just modifying it to make it a more structurally sound, besides the fact that it's also allowing it to contain more insulation to improve the R values.
We've essentially tried to incorporate solar thermal technology in a way that gives us the most performance possible. We have panels on our south wall, which might be slightly atypical, but when we get low sunlight in the winter and the sun stays near the horizon, we get exceedingly high output out of those solar panels, just as high as, for instance, we do out of the roof panels during the summer.
Here's a real life, practical application of design, engineering and architecture, construction, that these students, they wouldn't have had an opportunity to work on this had it not been for this project. So it's really high value for many reasons, and it's been really inspirational to work with these students. I just can't believe how much energy they've given to the project.
Earlier on, we've had problems communicating across the table. You work in different disciplines, you have different fields, and there's a different set of language that you establish. And so it took us a while to understand where each other came from and what we were trying to communicate, but I think our team is far enough along now that we're doing really well in terms of communication.
I almost get teary when I talk about this. Look, I did. The students are so amazing. I mean, the engineering students and the architecture students, the construction students, the interior students, the graphic students, they've all just totally risen to the occasion, and they are so committed, so smart, so strategic, so just in there to be on the team and do whatever it takes.
It's got me really pumped about the future of this business, and when I eventually get done with school someday, it's something that I'll definitely consider getting involved in.